And now it's action time! Create a new project with the same structure that we used during the rest of the course. You will need the following files: mux1bit.v and tbmux.v. Please make a new file called mux1bit.v with the following content. Feel free to pause the video. The most important step in implementing the circuit from the schematic is to name all the logic gates and wires. After this, it is very easy to implement this design using Verilog built-in primitives. Please check by yourself if there is a one-to-one correspondence between the elements of the schematic and the Verilog code. This code should be trivial for you to understand. Please make a new file called tbmux.v with the following content. Feel free to pause the video. The test bench has a simple standard structure, which is the following. We declare the test bench variables at line 5. We instantiate the dude at line 12 and connect it with the test bench variables. And at line 20, we generate the stimulus by doing some combinations between A, B, and X. Feel free to add more stimulus. After you run the simulation, you should see this in your waveform. Initially, all the values are X, because we start assigning values after 1 microsecond. After this, A is 1, B is 0, and X is 1. This means that we are going to select the value of B to be driven outside. So, you can see that Y is 0. After this, A, B, and X get all inverted. This means that we are going to select the value of A and drive it at the output. So Y is still 0. Next, X changes and it will drive at the output the value of B, which is 1. Please analyze by yourself the next steps in the circuit's operation.